Good day to Dinarans on the go and in the know, October 25th, 2019, no hype, no BS, just the facts. Hit the like and subscribe button so you don't miss out on my next post. I encourage you, knowledge is power, stay informed and stay alert, and know that today, we are one day closer than yesterday. First article of interest, Abdul Mahdi, the resignation of the government now without an alternative means leaving the country to chaos. October 25, 2019 Baghdad News, Prime Minister Adel Abdul Mahdi said Friday that the resignation of the government today without providing an alternative means leaving the country to chaos, while noting that some believe that my previous resignations is a position of weakness. The current government is the first government to prepare a scientific ministerial curriculum and offer a fundamentalist government program, he said, indicating that the call to overthrow the government and early elections and constitutional amendments is a legitimate and unequivocal right and we must develop it for our future, and the government and I will be pleased if this happens in these contexts. As for the pressure and the portrayal of the people that this is possible outside these contexts, these are adventures that Iraq has paid for repeatedly, he said. He stressed that some believe that my previous resignations is a position of weakness, but it was a protest against the situation and a warning of the danger of accumulation, pointing out that I regret to see many who are rejecting our calls for reform under the pretext of the existence of conspiracies today stand at the top of those demanding the resignation of the government without carrying themselves. It is the responsibility of pushing things into these levels of services and corruption. The resignation of the government today without providing an alternative means leaving the country to anarchy and this goes against calls for reform. He said, next article of interest, Parliamentary Assembly, we will try all the heads of corruption since 2003 and until now, Baghdad, Euphrates News October 25, 2019 9-12, member of the Assembly of the Assembly for the Correction and Change Rep, Al-Musawi said in a statement received by the Euphrates News that members of this parliamentary group are serious about overthrowing the heads of corruption that have exhausted the state since 2003 and until now to try them. Musawi hinted that accountability of the corrupt will not be exempted from one, noting that the gathering warned all its members that any cover-up or concealment of information about the head of corruption is tantamount to cooperation with him. Next article of interest, urgent OHCHR, 30 killed and 23-12 injured in today's demonstrations, October 25, 2019 22-16 Baghdad, the Iraqi Human Rights Commission. The number of victims of demonstrations during the popular demonstrations witnessed in the country today, OHCHR has documented the following, 1. The number of martyrs of demonstrators rose to 30, martyrs in the clashes that took place between the security forces and the protection of party, Baghdad 8 martyrs, Meissen 9 martyrs, Dhekar 9 martyrs, Basra 3 martyrs, Methana 1 martyr, 2. The number of injured to 23-12, demonstrators and security forces as follows, Baghdad Governor 8 1493 injured, Dhekar Governor 8 90, Wasit Governor 8 10, Methana Governor 8 151, Basra Governor 8 301, Diwaniya Governor 8 112, Meissen Governor 8 105, Karbala Governor 8 50, 3, burning and damaging 50 government buildings and party headquarters in the governorates of Diwaniya, Meissen, Wasit, Dhekar, Basra and Babylon. 4. Declaration of curfew in the province of Dhekar, Basra, Methana and Wasit. 5. UNHCR calls on all demonstrators to maintain peaceful demonstrations and not to prejudice public and private property and call on security forces to preserve the lives of demonstrators. Next article of interest, op-ed, U.S. deadline to withdraw transiting troops from Iraq is 4 weeks, by Ken Hanley Digital Journal, U.S. Defense Secretary Mark Esper was in Baghdad, the capital of Iraq, on Wednesday where he met with top Iraq officials. No doubt the talks involved damage control after the U.S. deployed troops from Syria into western Iraq without asking Iraq's permission. Iraqi officials had been publicly very unhappy with the U.S. troops just showing up in western Iraq without even having asked permission apparently. Prime Minister Adi Abdul Mahdi has said that Iraq intended to take all international legal measures over the matter, and called on the international community and the UN to perform their roles with regard to the matter. This may not be necessary as Mark Esper seems to have worked out a deal with the Iraqi defense minister. Iraqi defense minister announces troop withdrawal within 4 weeks. The Iraqi Defense Minister Najah Shamari made the announcement after his meeting with Esper. U.S. troops withdrawing from northeastern Syria to Iraq are transiting and will leave the country within 4 weeks, Iraq Defense Minister said Wednesday. Najah al-Shamari made the remarks to the Associated Press following a meeting in Baghdad with visiting U.S. Defense Secretary Mark Esper, who arrived as Iraqi leaders chafed over reports the U.S. may want to increase the number of troops based in Iraq, at least temporarily. Even 4 weeks may be regarded as too long by some critics. There were only 700 troops in all moved from Syria to western Iraq. It is not clear why it will take 4 weeks to remove them. There appears to be no apology for the U.S. action, and the U.S. seems to be taking its time in removing the troops. The Iraqi government is already having trouble containing opposition annoyance at the U.S. presence in Iraq. The U.S. actions may result in a resolution passing the Iraqi parliament demanding that all U.S. troops be removed from the country. The important Shiite faction of Miqdada al-Sadr is already demanding all the U.S. troops withdraw from Iraq. Next article of interest. Urgent agenda of the urgent and extraordinary session of Parliament tomorrow. Baghdad, Euphrates News, October 25, 2019, 21:30. House of Representatives on Saturday to convene an urgent and extraordinary session to discuss the demands of the demonstrators. The presidency of the House of Representatives in a statement received Euphrates News a copy of it. The parliament will hold on Saturday an urgent and special session to discuss the demands of the demonstrators and the decisions of the Council of Ministers and the implementation of reform packages. Session 11 will be held at 1 p.m., she added. Next article of interest. Tax adjustment and investor support contribute to reform. Baghdad/Mustafa al-Hashemi Friday, October 25, 2019. While many economists are demanding to quote global experiences and apply the appropriate ones in Iraq, economist Dr. Asim Mahali pointed out that the closest international experience of the Iraqi economy is the experience of Brazil, which witnessed a recovery after a severe economic crisis weighed down by the budget of the International Monetary Fund, salaries for poor families. Al-Mahali told Al-Sabah that the country's president, Lula da Silva, had put an item in Brazil's general budget called direct social subsidies, worth 0.5% of the country's gross national product, which is paid directly to poor families. This means replacing in-kind subsidies with cash support of $735. Which was paid to 11 million families, including 64 million Brazilians. But how is Brazil bankrupt? The answer is that it raised taxes on everyone except those subsidized by the subsidy program and limited it to businessmen and wealthy people. Investment facilities. The businessmen agreed to this simply because it gave them great investment facilities, the mechanism to operate and operate their businesses, granting them free land, facilitating licenses, giving small interest loans that help them open new markets, and the income of the poor will rise, he added. The process of buying business products doubled their turnover so they didn't feel it levy. He explained that businessmen are paying taxes for these facilities, adding that after 3 years, 2 million Brazilian immigrants and 1.5 million foreigners returned to invest and live in Brazil. Even the IMF borrowed $14 billion from Brazil during the global crisis in 2008. He said. Owns the four things. Brazil's economy has risen thanks to a focus on four things: industry, mining, agriculture and education, he said, adding that Brazil is now making aircraft the Brazilian-made fleet of imperial aircraft. The poorest of all, it is the state to dispense with many luxuries to support the poor. Al-Mahali stressed that the recovery from underdevelopment is not impossible, but it is the implementation of the will and the application of good management standards that will overturn the economic system from a purely consumer to a product within a few years. Only if the management of the economic file properly was exploited the resources available in Iraq and develop the reality of industry, agriculture, attention to the poor and productive groups, and the quality of education. He pointed out that Iraq has resources not owned by any country in the world. In addition to that, the country has a good reputation in the global markets to pay its debts and dues, both external and internal. Next article of interest. The Iraqi Deposit Guarantee Company receives a certificate of incorporation. Baghdad Morning Friday, October 25, 2019. The Central Bank of Iraq, the Department of Companies registration in the Ministry of Commerce to grant the certificate of the establishment of the Iraqi company to ensure deposit/joint stock. in accordance with the provisions of Article 19 of the Companies Law No. 21, for the year 1997 amended. A statement of the bank received a morning a copy of it that the Iraqi Deposit Insurance Corporation was established with the participation of 42 banks, and the number rose after the IPO session to 63 banks, including 7 government banks and 40 private Iraqi banks, and 16, in addition to 4 government and mixed companies, as well as the National Pension Agency/State Employees Pension Fund. The capital of the company is 100 billion dinars. Deposit insurance companies have been found to bolster efforts to stabilize the financial and banking system wreck. Next article of interest, mobile banking services. Friday, October 25, 2019, Baghdad. It appears that the CBI is proceeding with the implementation of the strategy of financial inclusion, establishing a banking reality capable of providing digital services based on modern technologies, and up to the level of the banking industry globalism. After talking about e-travel cards, the central bank directed all the licensed banks to introduce mobile banking over the next 6 months, under which the public will receive banking services through mobile phones. Through the mobile phone can conduct transactions and transferred funds between customers' accounts by linking money transfer services between banks electronically, and give the customer access to the details of financial accounts with the possibility of requesting a statement of banking operations, as well as access to the details of services and loan statement, credit cards and payment, as well as contacting the customer service center on everything related to services. The process is done by accessing an application for this service, using a username and password for each customer that can be changed when necessary, by sending an email or SMS alert when indirect login attempts or any other operation, such as making transfers, denial of access, change or reset the customer's password TC. It is certain that the banking sector is moving slowly towards digital services, which means that there is a new reality that imposes itself on the structural imbalances suffered by the sector over the years, which will make the restructuring of government banks a reality, not only at the level of technology introduction but at the level of departments and cadres. The entry of mobile banking is one of the most prominent outputs of the comprehensive banking system, which means the need to leave the manual work and the decline of paper trades, and therefore we will engage in new mechanisms and concepts such as the use of electronic signature mechanism and procedures error the mechanism to identify the customer by using the password once OTP, and could not be part of a state of change. The change will lead him out of the yard the work. And last but not least, we have a tweet by the Iraqi government today stating, Government of Iraq, at Iraqi Govt, PM at Adel Abd al-Mahdi. We will work with Parliament to pass a national oil and gas law so that all oil exports, including those from the Kurdistan region of Iraq, comply with and are governed by a unified national policy for the benefit of all Iraqis. 6:47 a.m. October 25, 2019, followed by this tweet, Government of Iraq, at Iraqi Govt, PM at Adel Abd al-Mahdi. We will hold a regional conference to be attended by countries neighboring Iraq to calm tensions in the region, refocus efforts on fighting terrorism and to keep Iraq out of regional or international disputes. 6:47 a.m. October 25, 2019. More articles of interest to come. Hit that subscribe button and the alert bell so you don't miss my next post. I encourage you, knowledge is power. Stay informed and stay alert. Over and out for now, the Dinarian.